Gabriella Ray, and I present to you the growing global crisis in biodiversity endangerment. Problem statement. As years go on, freshwater scarcity is slowly but effectively becoming an issue. Climate change that causes erosion is polluting freshwater sources with toxic minerals and minerals like lead, arsenic, mercury, chromium, copper, and so on. This issue can greatly affect the climate around those areas, making the water unusable and undrinkable for humans, plants, and animals. There is a problem with water salinization, despite the fact that water preservation, recycling, and reducing climate change should be acted on, erosion and pollution still take place. This issue has negatively impacted humans, plants, and animals that all need fresh water to survive. Erosion is a byproduct of climate change, which is said to be the main reason of this issue. Perhaps a study which investigates the negative effects of this issue through experimentation can promote awareness. My research question is, what will be the outcome of saline polluted freshwater sources such as lakes, rivers, and ponds to biodiverse areas? Now here are some definitions to keep in mind. Fresh water is water that does not contain salt, where animals, plants do not, they live in the intestines. Biodiversity is the biological variety and variability of life on Earth. Biodiversity is a measure of variation at the genetic, species, and ecosystem level. Erosion is the process of eroding or being eroded by wind, water, or other natural agents. Heavy metals are metals with relatively high densities, atomic weights, or atomic numbers. And pH level is a scale used to specify acidic or basic aqueous solutions. And here's an example of that scale that I use for my project. Starting with zero is the most acidic. With the green colors, that's neutral. And then starting with purple and blue, that's alkaline, which means it's very safe to drink. My project goal is to find the main cause of saline pollution to the samples that have been taken, also to gain a better understanding of biodiversity loss and why it takes place. Taking proper and professional samples for my experiment is also a goal, and I also want to spread awareness so that change may occur. Assumptions and hypotheses. The pH levels of present freshwater sources will have greatly increased as climate change remains to worsen. If climate change continues to be untreated and remains to pollute freshwater sources, biodiversity will suffer. This can lead to the extinction and endangerment of many freshwater species, plants, and more. Significance. Humans cannot drink salt water. It is toxic and dehydrates the human body. Making people more aware to this issue can help change a possible negative future to a more positive one. People need to be aware of the issues and dangers that already exist in the bottled water industry regarding chemicals that are purposefully placed, such as desalination, which is an example. Freshwater biodiversity constitute a valuable natural resource in economic, cultural, scientific, and educational terms. Their conservation and management are critical to the interests of all humans, nations, and governments. Yet, freshwater biodiversity is endangered. I use a mix between two methods, the hybrid and the Delphi method. Using the Delphi method, I ask professional marine biologists and scientists their thoughts in the comments regarding my topic. I then use the hybrid method to combine my research with professional research by doing an experiment. For my experiment, I compared water sources. With my experiment, I also looked for a difference in pattern from past, present, and possibly future water sources. This is an example of the chart that I use for why I chose this method. Knowing I wanted to conduct an experiment and also interview people in the marine biology field is a reason why, and I knew that I could combine those two together. Also, these methods made the most sense regarding my project, and I had a better understanding of these methods than all the other ones that I learned. Context. I used data from past recordings to compare that to my own findings, in other words, present sources. Using the past and present, I can infer and make an educated guess regarding what is to come. I use this graph that was taken from EPA. It is a measurement of rising sea levels from 1860 to 2020 from Lake Michigan. Data sources. I use two types of data sources, primary and secondary. My primary sources include asking factual and opinionated questions for professional marine biologists. I also will be taking samples of freshwater sources, such as the Money Reservoir and well water from my home. My secondary sources include articles of past freshwater source pollutants. So these are my examples that I take. This one is from the Money Reservoir. This is a table that consists of five trials, also recording the color of the pH strip, which determines why the pH level is that number. And then this is from the well water from my house. Each group was relatively consistent, but the Money Reservoir was slightly more acidic from the well water collected from my home. So these were a little more greener than the ones from the Money Reservoir. Ethical consideration. I kept ethics because my project did not involve experimentation on living organisms, nor did it disturb the environment surrounding the freshwater sources. None of the questions that were asked were personal, and the samples that were taken were obtained in a professional manner. Next step. The next researcher should consider expanding the field in which my project occurred, say, as an example, going out of money. Also, more samples of different freshwater sources should take place as well. The next researcher should lastly expand and dive deeper into biodiversity and data. What is missing? Exact species and living organisms that are affected by saline pollution, such as fish, birds, and algae, and are missing. Expansion into biodiversity is also missing. In the beginning of my project, I wanted to come up with some sort of solution or closure to saline pollution, but due to time, it did not go into play. Lastly, the exact cause of the saline pollution that occurs regarding if heavy metals, erosion, or both are the cause is also missing. Potential issues are the next researcher could face is not getting responses from mentors. Many of my mentors have very busy schedules, which make communication difficult. Not having the proper tools can also be an issue, as this is a hands-on experiment. Not getting enough data can cause issues, as a low amount of data can cause and make your results seem inaccurate and unreliable. A final issue is time. Having and making time to get the supplies needed, obtain the variables, and then conduct the actual experiment can be troublesome. Overall, I hope we can all change our bad habits to ensure a brighter future and save the plants, waters, animals, and humans that reside on Earth. Thank you so much for your time. This concludes my project.
I have three questions for you. What was one obstacle or challenge you encountered while implementing your research method, and how did you address it?
Definitely would be combining professional research with my own research, because I couldn't exactly figure out a way that the research taken and knowledge from these professional marine biologists would affect and kind of relate to my experiment. But in a way, I figured out how to do so with by asking them how to take proper samples so that everything done is in a real way.
Okay. Your second question, how might your conclusions, findings, or product relate to the current body of work in the community or field?
Since this was done in a more home and close area, I feel like this can help expand the research field, because we know that this issue is more close to home than we think, and that these problems do not just occur in bigger areas such as Lake Michigan. And
lastly, if you had three more months to work on your research question, what additional research strategies would you put into practice?
I would definitely say working more on biodiversity endangerment, because I didn't get to sample or test any animals or plants that are affected by freshwater biodiversity, which is in my research question, and I would like to expand more on that to have a more in-depth research conclusion and results.
Thank you.